So you may or may not be aware of the Visual Studio Code icon change. The too long didn't read version is now, it's switching back to a blue version, which takes inspiration from the new logo, but isn't orange. You can scroll down and you can see all of the various early icon designs for the change, but many people didn't really like this orange version. To be honest, I didn't really mind it that much, but a lot of people did. If we take a look at the Visual Studio Code repository, we can see a GitHub issue which has 272 comments, which everybody is pretty much slating the icon and saying it's ugly. This is the previous orange icon, and if we take a look at that, it doesn't look too bad, but I can definitely see where people are coming from. If we also hit Alt-Tab, we can see the current one here on Visual Studio Code. And a lot of the big complaints that kept coming up a lot is that it's quite similar to the Sublime logo. The Sublime logo is obviously very orange and black, similar to what would have been the Visual Studio Code icon. And we even have people calling it what's known as the Visual Studio Code Halloween Edition. And it turns out that Microsoft have listened to this and they want to now change the icon back to being blue. But my question to you is, what do you think of the icon itself? Tell me, are you a fan of the orange icon? Have you switched out your icon to be a different icon? And do you like the blue, now revised icon? I think it's nice that Microsoft are pioneering the next version of text editors and of course listening to community feedback. Something simple as an icon with 300 GitHub comments should really tell you just how big this community is. So, do you like orange, blue, or even the green inside a build? Let me know inside the comment section below and what you're working on this week. I've actually been thinking about more and more making more iOS and Android tutorials, as well as these Ionic and NativeScript and just about everything else. Let me know what you'd like to see in the comment section below for the future content of the channel. And if you'd like to support the channel, don't forget to check out my Patreon. That's patreon.com/paulhalliday. I'd love to be in a position where we don't really have to charge for the courses at all, and I can stick everything out on YouTube. Nonetheless, the current support of everyone on Patreon is allowing me to pursue YouTube as much as possible. I'm aiming for at least one or two videos a day, so if you could let me know what content you like the most and you want to see in the future, that would be great. So, blue or orange? Well, for me, I think it's going to be the blue, but the orange, I really didn't mind that much. Let me know. I'll see you in the next video coming up very soon.